Hi and welcome to my channel. So my name is Nienke de Glas, I'm a clinical epidemiologist, and here I'm doing a series with SPSS tutorials for beginners. So in this video we will cover the basics of how you can start working, making and changing your own variables. And I will show you how you can do this in menus, but also in using syntax. And if you've never used syntax before, I recommend that you start watching my previous video, in which I teach you how you can use syntax. So let's get started. So let's take a look at SPSS. So I've already opened my database here, and we will start making a new variable using the variable commands menus. So there are basically three ways that we can make new variables in this menu. We can either use compute variable and then recode into same variables or into different variables. So let's start using the compute variable. And this is especially helpful if you want to do either a mathematical calculation or if you want to extract data from other variables. But you can actually use it for basically any new variable that you want to make. So let's say we want to make a new variable in which we define several age categories. So we will call the new variable age groups. And we will obviously need age as a basis for this one. And here we need to define the groups that we will be making. So let's say that category number one is all patients under the age of 70. And in this menu, we need to define the different groups using the if command here. So age groups is one if, and then we go here. And you can either use all cases, but in this case, we will define it as age. Click it into here, is lower than 70. We press OK, and now we could either press OK and then it would make the new variable, or we could use the paste command and it will copy paste it into syntax. And as I discussed in my previous video, I would recommend that you always use the paste command. So now we go to the syntax viewer over here. You can see it's very easy syntax. You can remember this maybe and use it next time and type it yourself. Maybe doesn't have to, you don't have to, but you can. I always like to define what I'm doing here. So I'm making age categories using an asterisk here in front to make it gray. And I could run it already, or I could finish my syntax. So because now I've only defined the first group. So I could go back then, do exactly the same thing, define this as group two, then say age is higher or equal to 70. And then again, press paste. Or I could have simply copy-pasted this line, that would be much quicker. And then change this one into 2, and then here into is 70. So that's another way to do it. So you can either use the menu again, or you can type your own syntax. So now we will run this one. And in the output viewer, you can now see if SPSS actually did what you asked him to. And yes, there were no errors, so it works. So when I've made a new variable, I always like to check whether I did this correctly. And the way to do that is to cross-tab the old variable with the new variable. And you can do this by going to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then Cross-tabs. And here you can enter the groups that you want to compare. So for this one I've done before, I know that it's correct, but you can use this to see whether you've actually put the right patient in the right group. So now let's look at another option, which it might even be easier if you want to make a variable like this. So let me remove the variable that we previously made. So I will clear the age groups. So now we will use the menu of recoding into different variables. So we go to transform, recode into different variables. Here we need to define the old variable and the new variable. So we'll give it a new name. Again, we'll say age groups. And I always like to label the variable immediately. So I would like to say age groups under 70 versus over 70. And I will need to press change, because then you will see here that actually the name of the new variable occurs. And here you can define the old and the new values. So you can do this either by using an old value here and entering a new value here. So let's say you could all do this by hand. So if a person is 65 years, here the new value would be 1, but then of course it would take you a lot of time. So luckily SPSS has the option to enter a range here, or even lowest through a certain range, or the highest, the value through the highest. So in this case, I make it easy for myself, and I simply press here 0 to 1 is 1. Sorry. So here I type 0 to 70 is 1, or 71 through, well, let's say 120, nobody will be older than that, is 2. But of course, I could also have used the option down below here. So also don't forget to define missing values. So let's say that you have a variable where you have know that there's a lot of missing data, but you want to define this as a category in your data. So let's say that if there were patients in whom we would not know the age, it would be system missing. And we could say that a missing value is a 99 in my new variable. We could enter that, but I know that in my dataset there are no missing values for age, but we could use this. And then again, we press paste, and we will see it in our syntax again. You will see it look, you can see that it now looks a little bit different, because you can see here that SPSS has defined a few ranges in which the variable will be changed. So here it says recode the old variable into the new variable, and it also gives you immediately the variable label. So that's the disadvantage of this way. It doesn't give you the label immediately, but in this one it does. And I think it's a bit more easy. But both ways, of course, are completely fine. And again, you can use this syntax to make other variables now. You can copy paste it, or if you remember it, you can use it the next time. So let's run it again, and you will see that the output is exactly the same, and the groups are exactly the same in as the way that you've done before. So now let's say that we want to change something within a certain variable. So let's say, for example, that we now want to switch around the older and the younger age groups within the variable that we just made. We can go to the menu and then recode into same variables. We take the variable that we just made, take the old and the new values, and we can simply switch them around. So we can say 1 is now a 2, and a 2 is now a 1. Don't forget to press add, because if it's not here, then it will not pick up in the actual syntax. Again, we press paste, and we can see the syntax here. And you can see it's quite easy syntax. It's easy to remember, easy to use without menus at some point. We can select it, press play, and now you will see that it has changed. Importantly, we need to define some values here. And this is, in my opinion, a bit of a flaw with SPSS. We can do this here by hand, but then there's no syntax. And if we make a mistake, or if we want to use this again, then we need to do it by hand again. So in my opinion, it's really annoying that there's no menu for this that we can press paste and then get it in our syntax. So when something like this occurs, then what I usually like to do is I go to Google and I simply Google how can I make values in SPSS syntax and then use it that way. So, of course, I've done this many times before, so I know it from the top of my head. But if you would enter this in Google, you would find it also very easily. So here we would type in value labels, then mention the variable that we want to apply labels to. And you can see when syntax isn't finished yet, it becomes red. So now you know that there's something missing or there's something wrong. And we now need to define the label. So we need to say that 1 is 70 years or older, and 2 is younger than 70 years. It's probably a better way to do this, but for now this is good. So you need to finish this with a dot, because then SPSS knows that your syntax is finished. And then if we would run this, we can now see that there are values here attached to the variable. So now we'll show you how you can use the compute command in more detail, because it has many options when you need to do more detailed or more complex new variables. So let's go back here. And here you can take a look at several function groups. So let's say, first of all, I will reset this one. So let's say we have two dates and you want to know the time in between of the two dates. That's something that you often might be doing. So let's say you want to calculate the follow-up time. SPSS really has a nice explanation within this window. So if you want to do some calculations with dates, obviously you would need a group of data arithmetic. And here it gives you some options. So in this case, we would be interested in the difference between two dates. And here it would immediately show you how you need to enter the information. So here you could say date div, and then it tells you what information you need to enter. So let's say date 1, comma date 2, and then you need to formalize the unit. So days, for example, you would give it a test variable name. And now you could really enter here your own information, obviously. So this is really a nice option of SPSS because it really gives an explanation of the variable within the menu. So the calculations with dates is something that I like to use a lot, but there are many other options. And you can simply press through here and search for the things that you might be interested in using. And you could even make your own formulas here. So if you want to get the sum of several variables combined, you could simply say a new variable is the sum of variable x, y, and z together. And things like that might be really helpful. So the compute variable menu is a more sophisticated way to make variables, especially if you want to combine several variables or if you need more extensive options, as I've shown you here. So there you go. I've shown you the basics on how you can make variables in SPSS. Again, I would really recommend that you do this using syntax, because if you get a new update of your dataset, you can simply run all your variable names and your variable labels in syntax all at once, and you will really be grateful to yourself for doing that, and it will save you a lot of time. So I hope this was helpful. If you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up and please do subscribe to my channel. And I'm really looking forward to see you next time for my next SPSS tutorial within this series.